HKM TV presents Girls Varsity Basketball, and tonight we have a contest between the Hopkinton Hillers and the Holliston Panthers. Hi, I'm Tim Hladd, here with my partner Steve Spector. And Steve, the Hillers are coming in hot, winners of 8 in a row.
Yeah, you know, we've seen a few of the home games here in that stretch, and they have absolutely dominated, you know, the rest of the Tri-Valley League, including beating Medfield recently, their previous game by 30 points, if I heard that correctly. I wasn't sure if that was a typo, but I guess it's correct. Mm-hmm. And Medfield was undefeated at that time, if that's...
Yep.
So, you know, the Holliston Panthers tonight are going to have their hands full tonight.
They're worked cut out for them.
Definitely, certainly. No question about it. And they're fighting for their playoff lives to try to make the playoffs. They're 6-9, so... Mm-hmm. Should be a great game.
Right. Included in that win streak for Hopkinton, wins over Millis, who is always a strong contender in the postseason. Medway, who was a handful for them last year, and a win over Westwood, too, who before Hopkinton had got their hands on him was undefeated in the TVL. So no shortage of a competition thus far for the Hillers. But like you said, they've been playing very, very well.
Boy, they're really on a roll right now. And, you know, the rest of the Tri-Valley League has got to contend with the big three, or, you know, in terms of height anyway. We've got, mm-hmm. there might be four of them, I've lost track, but, you know, you got Julie Canestrari, mm-hmm. Reagan Kiveny, and Ivy Gogolin, all over 6 feet tall, and Michaela Pucci playing as if she's about 6'3",
right.
with her baseline moves and stuff. So I really think the Panthers are going to have a hard time dealing with really a very experienced and very polished Hopkinton team tonight. So we'll see. It's a Friday night in the Athletic Center, and you can kind of feel the energy. It's senior night, and a lot happening here tonight.
That's right. And hopefully we see a repeat of what happened the first time these teams met, where at Holliston, Hopkinton recorded a 70-36 victory. So still a game to play tonight, but things are looking good in terms of the Hillers.
No question about it, and, you know, that's quite a lopsided score from the first game. But, you know, what sometimes happens, Tim, as you know, when teams face each other the second time around, it can tighten up.
Right.
And for this, you know, I'm sure the Holliston Panthers are hoping that's going to happen tonight.
And in accordance with the senior night festivities here, we're going to be handing it off to Coach Mike Greco in a few moments.
Call up our seniors one at a time. I'll have them meet right here at half court, and you guys can line up in one nice big picture at the end. We'll start with number 10, Julia Canestrari. Her parents, Roger and Kate, and her sisters, Olivia and Emma. Next is number 12, Captain Emma Lukasha, along with her parents, Trisha and Chuck, and her brothers, Sam and Max. Next is number 14, Grace Marquardt, along with her parents, Gene and Steve. Next is number 15, Allie Maffiore, along with her parents, Mary and Keith. Next we have number 22, Lauren Hamm, with her parents, Julie and Richard, and her brother, Brian. Michaela Pucci, with her parents, King and Mike, and her brother Nate, and her sister Kyle. Thank you very much. Valley League is committed to the highest ideals of sportsmanship and establishing a healthy environment for interscholastic competition. The league will not tolerate negative statements nor actions directed towards competitors, game officials, nor fans in attendance. Such actions include taunting, trash talking, and the berating of players and/or officials. The Tri-Valley League has adopted a zero tolerance policy. Warnings will not be issued. Offenders will be ejected. Please respect all decisions made by officials. Please respect fans, coaches, participants alike. And now for the lineup of this evening's game. For the Holliston Panthers, number 5, junior captain Grace Zindelet. Number 10, sophomore Gabby Ramirez Rodor. Number 11, junior Abby Ray Wells. Number 12, sophomore Brooke Jeffroy. And number 15, junior captain Tess Powers. The Holliston Panthers are led by coach Dan Keefe. And now, your hometown Hawkins and Hillers. Number 23, sophomore Lily Morningstar. Number 44, junior captain Ivy Gogolin. Number 10, senior Julia Canestrari. Number 12, senior captain Emma Lakasha. And number 31, senior captain Michaela Pucci. The managers for the Hockington Hillers are Molly Birchman, Anne Conkowicz, Hallie Keith, and Grace Nealon. The Hockington Hillers are led by head coach Mike Greco. We now ask all fans in attendance to please rise, remove your caps, and honor the national anthem. Good luck, and go Hillers!
Tim Hladek and Steve Spector here, back with you now after our short break. And Steve, like we said before, Hillers winners of 8 in a row, an 11-2 record now, 11-1 in the TVL, and they sit firmly atop the TVL after those big wins over Westwood and Medfield.
Yeah, they, as I said earlier, they're on a roll. There's a lot of energy in the building tonight, senior night. It's great to see, I guess, half the roster on the Hockington Hillers are seniors, 6 out of 13 players, and as compared to the Holliston Panthers, who have one senior on their team tonight. So there's a ton of support here from the Hiller community. Mm-hmm. It's completely full and a loud and boisterous crowd singing the national anthem. With everybody. They were a little off-key being a musician myself, but that's okay.
Here we go.
It's going to be a great game tonight. Here we go.
All right. Just a moment away from tip-off. Ball is up. Gogolin taps it and somehow gets control of it. Hockington wins first possession of the game. Holliston starting out in man-to-man defensively. Pucci finds herself wide open. Then turns into a Holliston defender, hit with a foul. Pucci will be shooting too. That's the first foul on Brooke Jeffroy.
Yeah, she had her palms facing the ceiling, like as if what are you talking about, sir? I don't think she quite agreed with that call, but there was some contact, and Michaela's on the line for two.
First one off the back rim. Second one, almost the exact same thing, but Gogolin grabs the offensive board. Can't convert on her attempt. Ball bounces out of bounds, still in Hiller control.
Head coach of Holliston Panthers is a really great guy, Dan Keefe. I've known him from the AAU basketball years when my daughter played with his daughter a few years back. He's a wonderful guy and very enthusiastic, as you can see right there. So he's encouraging his girls to box out against the much taller Hiller girls.
Right, easier said than done, as we've seen.
Here we go. Yep.
Canestrari fires deep from three. No good. Morningstar gets the offensive rebound, though. Lakasha thought about the three. Now Morningstar drives, gets the ball poked away, recovered by Jeffroy. And a loose ball knocked out of bounds, still belongs to the Panthers.
Holliston kind of playing a swarming type of defense right now, and you know, as we said earlier, the Hillers girls took it to them earlier this year, almost doubled them up at 70-36 type of a score. But right now I'm sure they want to get a little revenge on that.
Lakasha takes the steal baseline. Now Gogolin has it, looking to score the first points of the game. Lazy pass, almost picked off. But Canestrari hits Gogolin with a nice bounce pass, and Gogolin is fouled and will shoot two.
Canestrari, nice take to the hoop, drew a couple of the Holliston girls to her, and then she kind of threaded the needle with a really cute little bounce pass to Ivy, and she's got two shots.
First one no good. Hockington 0-3 so far from the stripe.
I think we've seen that in the earlier games, Tim, when the Hillers, the girls, they seem to have missed a lot of their early foul shots, and then they sometimes get their momentum going later in the game.
Gogolin hits the second. Loose ball there, luckily corralled by Gabby Ramirez-Broder. Now Brooke Jeffroy down on the baseline, some contact, ball goes out of bounds, stays with Holliston.
Melanie Coleman of Holliston, really a nice idea. She kind of telegraphed that pass, and the Hill girls kind of intercepted it there.
Looking to get it in was Gabby Ramirez-Broder. She had no choice but to throw it off of a Hiller foot. Now she'll have another 5 seconds to see if she can get something going. Again with trouble, inside to Jeffroy. Her shot hits nothing and is grabbed by Canestrari. Now, Lily Morningstar, good play there to drive and took the tough foul there from Melanie Coleman.
Yeah, Melanie Coleman came into the game. I guess, I think, unless I missed it, but she wasn't announced as a starter.
No, she wasn't.
And she playing very aggressively, defensively, you can see that.
Canestrari drives and opens up an easy layup. The first basket, I should say, of the game for the Hillers, now with 3-0 lead. Coleman with it at the top of the key for Holliston, getting sworn by Lakasha and Gogolin. She tries to get it out, does get in the hands of Jeffroy. Crowd wanted to travel, and instead, Pucci is hit with a foul, as it looked like Holliston walked twice on the same possession. Neither violation was called, and they get two free throws out of it.
Yeah, that was unfortunate for Michaela. She looked like she made a pretty good block on that play, too, after those infractions that you just described. But Holliston worked for a pretty good shot, and there might have been a little contact there on Michaela's part, but we didn't see it from all the way up here. So.
And we do have the best seat in the house.
We do. And we're always right. So.
The sophomore Jeffroy hits two free throws, now a 3-2 lead for Hopkinton. Just under 6 minutes left here in the opening quarter. Morningstar drives, nice pass to Gogolin. She takes the foul and one. Great play there by Morningstar and Gogolin on the give and go.
That was a nice give and go, and then Ivy really took advantage of her height, and that, you know, number, I can't tell who it was. It might have been number 10, Gabby Ramirez-Brodor. Just couldn't really deal with that major height differential.
Gogolin misses the free throw. Oh, Pucci,
like
offensive rebound.
There, but.
You're right. I was about to say, Pucci, no foul call, but luckily Morningstar keeps her head up, takes the second offensive rebound, and puts it home. 7-2 lead now. Timeout Holliston.
Yeah, Coach Dan Keefe of Holliston has got his hands in his hips after a couple quick hoops from Hopkinton, and he's, this early part of the game is critical. He's trying to explain to his girls, you got to box out. There's various reasons why you should do that. You should do it anyway, but when you have a real deficiency in the height, you really have to do that.
Yeah, that's the only way you're going to get any rebounds.
Right, and that's all he can do over there. So he's got his hands. He and his team have their challenge ahead tonight, I think.
Certainly, their work cut out for them. And speaking of the Panthers, they enter into this game with a 6-9 record overall, 6-7 in the TVL. In their last three games, they have a win over Ashland, a win over Millis, and then a loss to Westwood. But that game was a close one, Westwood taking that 52-46. So they do have the capability of playing the top teams tough. We'll see if they can kind of change the early tune of this game.
Well, they certainly have some talented players. You can see that already. And again, with their coaching, and there's nothing like a Holliston-Hopkinton rivalry. That, you know, any pick a sport, there's always a good rivalry there. So, you know, Friday night, big game here. I'm sure Holliston's going to get everything they have here.
Rush pass there at half court. Kanastari takes it all the way by herself. The easy fast break lay-in. 9-2 now, Hopkinton. Shot from the baseline and getting fouled.
It's her second foul, I think.
Abby Ray Wells for Holliston.
Oh, that was, I'm sorry, it looked like it was Michaela, but it's actually.
Oh, no, look, we do have it. Yeah, that's
it
the second
that's
on
right.
Pucci.
That's right. I think you might see a substitution coming up in a minute here. Both of her fouls were somewhat questionable, I would have to say, and it's two fouls with only a few minutes into the game is probably not a good sign for Hopkinton, but I'm sure Coach Keefe of Holliston is probably enjoying that second foul being called.
Morningstar, who just took a break as Huebner came onto the floor, now is back on the floor again for Pucci, so no rest for the sophomore as the Hillers maintain a six-point advantage. Gogolin inside, turns around,
nice
partially
blocked
by Jeffroy. Now ball circulating around the three-point line for the Hillers. Less than 10 seconds on the shot clock. Lakasha stuck. They get it to Gogolin. Morningstar steps back for three, knocks it down. Lily Morningstar.
That was a big-time shot right there with the clock winding down, and she knew she only had a couple seconds, and she still got her took the time to get her shot, her leg set. It was a really nice release. Beautiful shot.
Errant pass there picked off by Gogolin. Now Morningstar has it again. Gogolin takes a step, fires a jumper, no good, gets her own rebound, and is fouled on the putback. Ivy Gogolin has been very aggressive thus far, and that's a good sign for the Hillers.
Well, in the last few games that we've seen her play here, she's sort of stepped up her game and really has a lot of momentum going on for the whole season. And, you know, let's see if she can knock a couple of free throws down.
And she takes your advice and knocks down the first one.
Right on cue.
10-point lead now for Hopkinton, 13-3 with 4:24 left in the first quarter. A lot of the action thus far taking place at the free throw line for the Hillers.
Looks like Callie Corby's in, giving Emma Lakasha a break.
As Gogolin knocks down both. Driving and finding herself wide open and knocking down the layup was Tess Powers.
Boys, the floodgates open there, and then she just saw the gap. She showed some pretty good speed there. She just burned down the middle of the floor and made a nice finish on that. Still a 9-point deficit, but not a bad move by the Holliston Panther, Tess Powers.
Yeah, clearly Coach Greco did not like what he saw there. Even with the 9-point advantage, just a complete defensive breakdown there as Powers was allowed to just kind of waltz right down the lane and take an open layup. Good play nonetheless for Holliston. Their second basket of the game in 6 minutes into the first quarter.
And there's a lot of points already. 14 points only, you know, halfway through the first quarter. This could be a big trend here. I'm not really sure. Maybe, Tim, you can help me out with all the student bodies standing up. Do they stand up until a certain point in time, or is there some sort of situation they're waiting for so they can sit down? Or are they going to stand up the whole game? Or?
They stand up the whole time, sit during halftime.
Okay, all right.
As far as I'm concerned, when I went to games.
I appreciate you clarifying that. I wasn't really sure.
Right. Yep.
All I know is that there's a lot of them. So.
Yes. It's good to see the support for this Hiller team.
Definitely.
Especially because I think you agree with me that they have a chance to take home some hardware this year.
I think so.
Gogolin turns around, fires the shot. No good. But again, she's looking for her own shot today. Not waiting for it to come to her. Looks like a foul called there on the loose ball, and Holliston will inbound.
I think it was a jump ball.
Was it a jump ball?
Yep.
Hopkinton playing aggressive defense here, not allowing the Panther ball handler any room as Coleman was forced to give it up along the baseline. Now down low, shot up, no good from Eliza Altobelli.
Boy, tough
now
shot.
She gets a second chance, and Altobelli knocks it down.
Boy, that was over a Ivy, which is quite a shot. Errant pass there.
Huebner, not quite sure where she wanted to put it, ended up throwing right to Holliston. Morningstar breaks free, called for a travel.
I didn't see the travel. Did you see that, Tim? I don't know.
It did not look like one. It looked like she just took two steps, but
in the NBA, there's no way that was a travel, but that was a...
I've seen Russell Westbrook walk halfway down the court with it.
Exactly. Oh. Ouch. That didn't look good.
Abby Ray Wells takes a tough spill to the floor. She gets up, looks to be all right, just shaking up a little bit.
That was just an accidental, the legs got crossed up, and boy, well, she's got some wheels. She was flying down there. If that's who that was it?
Yes, that was Wells, okay. Yep. And Wells has the ball again. Nice spin move there. Falling bounce pass. Apparently hit a Hiller because it is still Panther ball. And now subbing in for the first time is Kami Kazubal for Holliston.
We have Michaela back in the game with two fouls. We'll have to keep an eye on that.
Quick three taken off the mark. Tess Powers no good from beyond the arc. Now Morningstar has it for Hopkinton. Gets it down low to Pucci. Great pass to Gogolin, open. Draws the foul and can't convert, but we'll have two more free throws. Ivy Gogolin's having a very active first quarter here.
Looks like Brooke Jeffrey, number 12, was called for that one. She's one of the taller girls. She looks like she's over 6 feet tall, one of the only true height girls with height
right.
With Holliston here. I'm stuttering here, but that might have been her second foul.
Yeah, it was. Yep, she's taking a break right now.
And she's telling her coach, I just had my hands up. I wasn't doing anything. And he's agreeing with her. But nevertheless, she has her second foul. So I think that was probably a good move by Coach Keith to take her out.
Gogolin goes one of two from the line. And Hopkinton gets a rebound on her miss. Now Huebner drives, shot up, no good. Huebner somehow gets it back and forces a jump ball.
Good hustle by Huebner. And that was the right call by the refs. It's clearly a jump ball.
Corby open at the three-point line. Turns it down, drives, shot up.
Good idea.
Good-looking floater, can't get it to fall. And again, Huebner fighting for the ball, forces another jump ball. This one goes to Holliston, but a great play from Huebner nonetheless.
She's a scrappy player, Huebner. She's makes the most of her minutes when she gets on the floor, for sure.
Again, Hopkinton playing very tough defense on whoever is handling the ball for Holliston. And Huebner, again, sticks her hands in there, knocks the ball out. And another jump ball forced by Huebner, her third.
That's going to be a record. It's been less than 30 seconds.
Right.
She's got three jump balls. I don't know what the record is, but we'll have to look that one up.
She's definitely close. Ivy Gogolin takes a well-deserved rest. As Allie Maffior, the senior, makes her first appearance into this game. Hiller's moving the ball around side to side. Down low to Pucci. She takes a tough hit from Holliston's only senior, Rachel Elkinson, who was honored before the game. A nice gesture by Hopkinton. But she picks up her first.
Yeah, that was a nice gesture. She almost took Michaela out of the game in that play, but that was a lot of ball. She got all of that one on that one. But the refs got that one right, and no, you know, it wasn't intentional. They just collided.
Basketball is a contact sport.
Exactly. 1-1. And again, the Hillers are not exactly.
Right, we don't have the numbers in front of us, but
crushing it
they are struggling from the line.
Somewhere around 50% in that vicinity.
Powers, nice pass inside to Elkinson. She
nice.
Tried to pass it again. No good. Picked off by Hopkinton. and it looks like Pucci lost it out of bounds, and it will be Panther ball.
Hey, the Panthers are hanging in. They got to give them credit. 15-7 with about a minute and a half left in the first quarter, and they're definitely in the game.
Altabelli stuck with it, doesn't know where to go. Draws a foul in the paint.
The swarming type of a defense. She's kind of surrounded by a couple of Hiller girls, and looks like Kate Huebner got her second foul. She's going to come out of the game probably in a minute. Oh, how do you miss that?
Altabelli finds herself wide too open. Bad. Can't hit it, and getting her hands on it was Rachel Elkinson, forcing a jump ball.
Number 22 for the Panthers, Eliza Altabelli. She found herself with a ball wide open and had a little bunny for 2 points, and I think she anticipated that she was going to have someone in front of her, and it was just
maybe too open.
Exactly.
A nice turnaround jumper from Elkinson. She can't hit. Rebounded by Hopkinton. Nice pass from Canestrari. Head up. Thought about the shot. Looked up to find Pucci open under the basket. And
beautiful.
Two more points for Pucci. Jump shot from Powers. No good. And now Canestrari with it again. She looks up. Great pass again to Pucci. A bit too far under the basket for her. She can't finish. And Powers was looking to force the issue for Holliston. Had the ball knocked away by a Hiller. It remains Holliston ball.
A couple of really nice fast breaks. The ball wasn't even hitting the ground. And the Hillers scored on one of the two opportunities, but both plays were really nice. And they have a 10-point lead right now with about a minute left in the quarter.
Lakasha, tough defense there on Coleman. Gogolin, tough defense down in the paint. Nothing easy now for Holliston. Coleman drives, throws up the tough shot. Nothing doing there with Gogolin in front. But Altabelli stole the rebound away from Gogolin, but couldn't convert. Loose ball out of bounds, last touch by Hopkins.
I think the student body is really voicing their opinion on that lack
right.
of a foul. It looked like there was some contact on there, but no call.
Pass inside, handled by Kozubal. She turns, fires a shot, no good. Gogolin boxing out for the rebound. Canestrari takes it, drives, gets the layup to fall in. Nice move from the senior. And a timeout called by Holliston.
Oh, that's an interesting timeout with only 22 seconds left in the quarter. Canestrari made a really nice move. She's done that, we've seen that a few times this year, where she just takes those long two steps without traveling, and one of the Holliston girls, I think it was number 12, Brooke Jeffroy, and she did a good job getting out of the way to avoid getting
right.
A foul called on her. But nevertheless, Julia made a wonderful move to take it to the hoop and get 2 points.
And that opens up a 12-point lead for the Hillers, up 19-7. As you said, 22.3 seconds remaining in this one. Coach Dan Keefe maybe looking to at least get a basket before this final buzzer goes of the first.
Well, he coaches, I've known him for a little while. He's a really, he plays to win no matter what the score is. One play at a time, one possession at a time. So there's a good indication of that. He's got time for one shot. If he can, get a basket or a three-pointer or something before the quarter, that's, going to help his team out. You can definitely tell Holliston's not rolling over here. They're going to play to the end here. But we've said it a couple times. They had their work cut out for them tonight.
Inbounding it is Ramirez Broder. Gets it into Kozubal. Now pass down low, shot missed by Elkinson. Quick foul called on the rebound. Kozubal grabbed the rebound. She was fouled.
Looks like Allie Maffiore with her first foul of the game.
Hopkinton playing great defense on these inbounds plays as Morningstar lunges and knocks that one out. It gets to up to at least 3 or 4 seconds almost every time they're inbounding it. A tough one there again as the pass gets into Altabelli. 10 seconds left. Coleman with it at the three-point line. She loses it. somehow falls in the hands of Elkinson. She misses. 4 seconds left now. And Mafiore grabs the rebound and is fouled. Altabelli picking up the foul.
That's unfortunate with only a couple seconds left, way down the other end of the court. And I think Coach Keefe is saying, hey, not necessary. That was a one-on-one situation now. Gives Allie a couple, well, a one-on-one situation. So that'd be great for her, senior night. Mm-hmm. It's good to see her getting some good playing time tonight.
It's typically earlier than she enters into most
that's
games.
That's good for her. She's probably working hard in practice and earning every minute.
But with the depth that this Hiller team has, you have to earn it here.
They go deep, that's for sure.
Free throw no good, rebounded by Holliston, no shot on their end. So after one, Hopkinton takes a 19-7 lead going into the second quarter.
Well, geez, that's a pretty good amount of points, almost 20 points in the first quarter, so that's a pretty good pace. And you know, and they've missed a few opportunities. They could very well have
at
another
the free throw line. Could have another 5 or 6
absolutely.
Points.
Absolutely. And Holliston's kind of hanging around, but I think it's certainly a skating on thin ice, as they say. You know, this has the potential to open up quickly.
Right.
But it's good to see again a big crowd here. Some Holliston folks here as well. And I think the boys have a game at Holliston tonight. That's going to be a big game for them because Holliston boys, I think, are in first place in the TVL.
Yeah, they're at the top of the TVL with Medway and Westwood.
So, you know, it's a little dichotomy here with the boys' situation.
Right.
They're kind of fighting for their lives to get to the playoffs.
So are the Holliston girls,
exactly.
Too, right.
So we'll see. And then we have the Super Bowl on Sunday. So do you have a prediction, Tim, on how you think the game's going to go or score?
I'll keep that towards the end of the game. Keep the fans interested.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, kind of leave them. That's a tease almost, right?
Right, exactly. Hey, I'm practicing for the big time.
I
got to get ready.
There you go. And then we'll be back here Tuesday night for another home game. I have to check with my wife, but I think I can make it.
Yep, against Bellingham on the 7th.
So we'll have to verify your prediction.
Right.
I'm not even saying I'm going to give a prediction, but I'm going to ask you for your prediction. And we'll see if it comes true or not. I'll tell you my prediction. I think they're going to win 41 to about 20.
41.
I think they're going to double up on them.
All right.
I'm talking about the Patriots.
Bold words from Steve Spector here.
You heard it here first. So.
Second quarter starts. Pucci drives baseline. No one's stopping her. Aggressively towards the hoop. Another quick deuce for Michaela Pucci.
We've seen that move a few times this year. Oof. Bodies flying everywhere there.
Morningstar fighting for the ball. Not happy with the foul call, but giving every ounce of effort.
You know, both teams are in a one-and-one situation where the next foul on the Hillers will be one-and-one for Holliston. But it's only, you know, that's pretty early in the –
almost a full quarter of free throws.
That's a five-second call. Good defense by the Hillers.
There we go. I've been alluding to it all night, the Hiller pressure causing a lot of problems for the Panthers throwing it in. And there, their first five-second violation. Now Morningstar will inbound under the – Panther hoop. Canestrari turns and fires a quick three. Nothing but net.
Boy, she just nailed that one, man. That was a beautiful shot.
Did not even think about that. Caught it, squared up, knocked it down. Lakasha a little too aggressive there.
I think it's a one-on-one. I think Coach Greco was appreciating her effort. Which was, that's true. I don't blame him. Both teams in a one-on-one situation right now. Emma discarding her eyewear.
That's right.
So let's see how that works out. She's been playing really well with it, so maybe she's got the contact lenses in. Or we'll have to do our research at halftime and figure out
what
happened.
The insider scoop.
Exactly.
Second free throw, no good. Gogolin with the rebound. Up 24-8. Lakasha with it at the top of the key, calling out a play. Canestrari looks to get it to Gogolin. Nothing doing. Morningstar with the jumper just inside the three-point line. No good. Now Coleman with it for Holliston. Coleman drives.
Nice shot.
Nice bank shot. First basket of the quarter for Holliston.
24-10 lead for the Hillers at the moment.
Tough scoop layup for Michaela Pucci.
Boy, that's kind of created her own angle to get that shot off. Great play.
Akasha again playing aggressive defense. Finally, ball gets into Coleman's hand. She steps up, takes a three, too strong. Rebound grab.
Nice
now
pass.
Elkinson down low. Excuse me, that was Altobelli. Went up for the shot, got fouled. Now we'll shoot two.
Yeah, that was, nice perseverance, I guess, on Holliston's part. They're trying to scramble to get a decent shot off, and Altobelli did, and then Ivy kind of wiped her out there at the end, but there was definitely some body contact there.
First shot off the front rim for the sophomore forward.
Got Lauren Hamm, senior, entering the game for the first time tonight.
Altobelli prepares for her second. A bit too strong, now grabbed by Gogolin. Hamm travels up court with it. Now in the hands of Akasha. Holliston still in man-to-man. Akasha wants a pick. Ball gets to Gogolin. 3 seconds left. She stops, puts it up. Can't knock it down. Hamm tries to get in there for the offensive board. She can't grab it away. Now Powers takes it up court for Holliston. She gathers herself from almost just behind the free throw line and is kind of bailed out, I think, there with a foul. That would have been a tough shot for her, but instead now she has two from the line.
Yeah, that was Lauren Hamm getting her name in the scoring sheet with a foul here, first foul of the night. And Tess Powers at the line. She made up her mind about her own free throw line that she was going to the hoop on that play. Kind of a coast-to-coast deal, but she's got some speed. You can see when she gets the ball, she's got some wheels. So right.
Akasha open for three.
Back rim.
No good. Grabbed by Ramirez Broder. Down low. Nice turnaround move from Brooke Jeffroy. She can't finish. Great pass from Lauren Hamm to Ivy as the fast break lane goes in. Ivy Gogolin, great finish.
Yeah, and a nice pass, too, by Hamm. Threaded the needle on that one. Ooh, that was a little stutter step walk. I even caught that up here. It's tough when the ref is right behind you and you do that. Too bad for the Holliston girl, but that was the right call.
That travel on cause a ball. Another turnover for Holliston. Now pass inside to Gogolin. She turns around. Nice move. Doesn't get the friendly bounce. And now Powers has it for Holliston. Again, looks like she's looking to take it the whole way. She does. Spots up for three. Too strong. Grabbed by Hamm. Canestrari gets a little too greedy there. Tries to fire it into Gogolin. Powers.
Oh boy, that's
runs
a lot of
right
fun.
Into Hamm.
Boy, I don't blame the Holliston coach. There was some serious body contact there.
Gogolin had a nice block, but then Holliston seals it right back and causes a ball with a hard floater off the backboard. Now a 14-point lead for Hopkinton.
Nice finish there. Almost justice on that one because there was a foul earlier that wasn't called. Again, I'm still a Hiller at heart, but that was a heck of a move.
Akasha drives, gets the ball poked out from behind. Looks like it will stay with the Hillers. And I just noticed, Steve, that it looks like the Hiller faithful have taken a seat.
Yeah, so maybe it was the first
quarter. My prediction
quarter.
Was wrong. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe
we'll
midway kids are
different.
We'll
have to send you back to retraining if you don't know how this thing works. But I guess no. I guess it's a first quarter.
It's kids these days, you know.
I know, exactly.
Gogolin with 2 seconds left on the shot clock. Gathers himself, pulls up, and a foul called. Gogolin, I think this is going to be her 7th and 8th free throws, if not more. She's been very aggressive and is getting rewarded.
Yeah, she got bailed out a little bit because the shot clock was winding down with only a couple seconds left, and she got swarmed by 3 red shirts. Boy, I mean, not that it's a close game at the moment.
Right.
But the Hillers are allowing Holliston to remain in the game.
Right.
They could have another 8 or 10 points on the board. Not that they're going to hit every one of them, but they've missed a few.
Second one is good for Gogolin. But your point is right. If this game's closer, then it could end up being a problem at some point. Coleman drives now over to Ramirez Broder. Ball inside. Turned over, and Huebner comes up with it for Hopkinton. Lakasha open for 3, gets the pass, knocks it down.
Boy, senior night.
Corby finds Lakasha open, coming up on the left side of the court.
That's her second one.
And she knocks it down.
Those contact lenses must be working out pretty good for her.
Right. It appears so, as that opens up an 18-point lead now for Hopkinton. Shot fired from Powers. Well short of the rim. Ham tried to grab it. Bounces off her hands. Remains with Holliston. And now Ham will take a seat. And Marissa Prawl enters the game for the first time, the junior guard.
Good job by Lauren Ham, senior night. Nice assist. Playing some tough D. Getting her hands on the ball.
Lakasha sees the pass. Takes it away. Drives the whole way. And gets the tough layup to fall. Emma Lakasha.
Wow.
5 quick points.
Quite a big game she's having already. 20-point lead for the Hillers.
Coleman walks it up the court for Holliston. A lot of pressure by Huebner and by Corby. Spin move from Powers. Tough move, can't finish. Rebounded by Holliston. Elkinson can't finish either. Now Powers, another layup. She misses, and Gogolin finally comes down with the rebound. She takes it up herself. Good ball movement here by Hopkinton, really getting anything they want. Gogolin puts her head down. Charge called there. Considering some of the other calls we've seen that weren't called, I don't know about that one, but foul called nonetheless, and Holliston takes over.
I guess they called an offensive foul.
Yep, they called a charge on Ivy. Just her second of the game.
There was definitely some collision there. There's no question about it. But given the score, it's hard to debate or argue or complain about it when you have a 20-point lead, and that was.
But I'll find a way.
Yeah. Okay.
Coleman again bringing it up for the Panthers. Not much success offensively tonight with the swarming Hillers defense as Pucci steals another one away. Corby was open for 3, turned it down. Lakasha flashes to the middle of the free throw line. Pass back to Huebner. It was a good play, but Huebner took a step before she started dribbling and hit with a travel.
Yeah, that was similar call that they called on the Holliston player earlier, and it was, I guess if you're going to call that other one earlier, you have to call that one. That was fairly similar.
Abby Ray Wells back in the game for Holliston.
She's got some quickness, too.
Again, the swarming Hiller defense takes it away. Now Pucci with it. Turns around, finds Prawl. Now open up for the corner. Huebner for 3. Great ball movement from the Hillers. They are just executing their offense perfectly tonight. And that results in Huebner getting a wide open 3.
A nice shot, too. She hasn't had very many 3-pointers as far as I recall this season, so that's nice to see her launch one and just hit the bottom of the net.
Pucci takes it away. And then Coleman is hit with the foul as she tries to get it back. Michaela Pucci, again, very active defensively, as always. racking up those steal totals.
Got a double bonus. Both teams in a double bonus situation right now with 10 fouls each. A minute left or 59 seconds left in the half. 37-14 Hillers with a couple shots for Michaela.
She knocks the first one down. It looks like Mafiore's coming in for Pucci. Assuming she makes the second one. 38-14 lead for Hopkinton. Second one no good and grabbed by Tess Powers. Just under a minute now remaining in the first half. Holliston looking to close out
clear
this.
It out.
That was the left arm extended and pushing away the defender, Eliza Altabelli.
Well, they called a third foul on Michaela, I think.
And then to compound the mistake, the refs call a foul on Pucci.
Actually, it's 41?
41.
I think they meant 31.
Yeah, that must be a miscommunication there.
Could be a human error down at the scores table. I don't know if there's a 41 on the team, is there?
I really can't believe how they missed that clear out, though. Usually it takes a lot less than that to get the foul, and that was a tough one.
Yeah, that was unfortunate, but, you know, I don't think it necessarily is going to have an impact on the end result of the game, but, you know, three fouls is three fouls.
Huebner boxes out and grabs the rebound. Now Hopkinton on offense looking to add to this lead. 30 seconds left here in the half, 15 on the shot clock. Ball taken away. Coleman gets her hands in there and steals it away. Now Holliston can take the last shot of the half if they wish. 15 seconds left on the clock and counting. Pass inside, way too strong from Altabelli, sails over the nearest Panther. And Hopkinton will have 7.2 seconds left to get a shot off.
Yeah, Altabelli, she kind of threw a more of a line drive. It could have been a more of a pop-up pass, would have been a little more effective there.
And the Hillers tried to get the ball into Ali Mafiore. No luck there. And at the end of the first half, we have a 38-14 Hiller lead.
Well, you know, I don't know if it exactly worked out this way because my memory's starting to go, but it was approximately 19-7 after the first quarter. So,
You
know, doubled them up again. That's a pretty substantial and comfortable lead that the Hillers earned. And, again, as we mentioned, they're going to need to, you know, as the season gets along and the playoffs start to get a little closer, they're going to need to work on their free throw shooting. But if we want to offer some constructive feedback,
that's about the only thing that we could say.
I think so, but it's great to have a 24-point lead going into halftime on a Friday night, full house. So we'll be we certainly enjoying Friday night so far, and we have lots more to play in the second half. So
the Hillers paced by big halves from Ivy Gogolin and Michaela Pucci, and we are going to break, and we'll see you in a few minutes.
Do you have what it takes?
Will you make a difference?
Always an adventure.
Police and fire working together.
Utilizing the latest technology.
Do you have what it takes?
Are you worried about letting your child take the wheel? Maybe you should also be worried about what you're doing behind the wheel. Have you ever sent a quick text just this once? Well, that might turn into a catastrophic accident. Monkey see what monkey do. If you do it, why wouldn't your child? In a child's brain, almost all things their parents do, they can do too. 78% of teen drivers surveyed text and drive. 59% said their parents do it too. Stop texting and driving, because if you do it, your child will too.
All right, Tim Holladick and Steve Spector here back with you for the second half, which should start momentarily. The Hillers with a 24-point lead up 38-14.
Boy, you know, at the risk of sounding redundant, they, you know, the first quarter and second quarter were like a duplicate of each other. I think each, you know, 38 to 14, and it was 19-7 after the one quarter. So,
right.
Holliston, if they're going to have any chance of getting back in this game, they're going to have to do it quickly.
Right.
And we'll see how that rolls.
Right, not much time for the Panthers to get going here as they miss their first shot. On the floor is Huebner. Great save. Gogolin gets it back into Pucci. Canestrari stops for three. Just off the front of the rim and grabbed by Kozubal. Power stops, three, too strong, spins out. Kozubal with the rebound, just too short. And now Huebner with it for Hopkinton. Throws it down to Gogolin. Gogolin turns, blocked by Altobelli. Great play for the Panthers defensively.
Nice play.
Wells for three. A little too short, grabbed by Powers. Elaine opens up for her as she takes the offensive rebound and converts it into points.
Nice play.
Gogolin finds herself open too. The quick jumper is good. Lakasha finds her teammate.
Touche on that one. It only took about 4 seconds to respond to that first hoop. Nice shot by Ivy. She got herself squared up to the hoop. Didn't force it, didn't rush it.
Wells looking to drive. Dribbles across court. Coleman gets it inside. Kozubal turns, fires the nice shot. 40-18 now.
She's got some height too. There's a couple of tall girls on Holliston. She's one of them. Nice little turnaround.
A steal there. Kozubal again. By herself, but Canestrari comes from behind to, if not block, then alter the shot. And now Gogolin on the other end. Her jumper falls, or does not fall, rather. And Huebner grabs it, and she puts in the offensive rebound.
Might have been Pucci, but couldn't really tell. Nevertheless, good shot. Nice finish.
Kozubal again, just from behind the free throw line. No good. Pucci boxes out and gets the rebound. Huebner with it now, finds Pucci driving, turns and spins, and one. Michaela Pucci takes the foul from Altobelli, converts, and will try to make it an old-fashioned three-point shot at the line here.
Beautiful body control on that. She spun, nice spin move, and had the Holliston player on her back, and definitely some contact and a little spin off the glass for two, and she has a chance for an extra point here.
Pucci knocks it down.
This has the makings of a very big crooked number at the end of the night. 45-18 with a lot to go.
Yep, the Hillers have come out firing here in the opening moments of the third quarter. Not a good sign for Holliston. Wells catches and drives. The nice play. Can't finish. Ball ends up in the hands of Altobelli. Her shot rattles around. No good. Out of bounds. Hiller ball.
Well, I've seen this a few times. I don't think I've mentioned it yet, but you know, if the Hillers don't block the shot, I think the Panthers are just worried about getting the ball swatted, and it's altering the shots a lot. And you can see there's some discomfort,
some hesitation
for getting some of those shots off, and it's definitely impacted the way the shots are going off for the Holliston
Panthers. Canestrari takes a step in, nice shot. Fakes the three, draws the defender, takes a step in and knocks it down. Now a 29-point lead opened up here by Hopkinton. Kozubal drives, can't get the hook to fall. Pucci, another rebound. Huebner drives baseline. Coleman tried to get in front of her, could not, hit with the blocking foul.
That's quite a collision there.
Coleman's fourth foul of the game, and she is going to be taking a break here.
She plays pretty aggressively, and in that case, she got a little bit wasn't able to get out of the way and wasn't able to get her feet planted, so that was the right call.
Huebner again fouled at the three-point line. This time, Abby Ray Wells picks up the foul. Not much room on the bench there for Holliston if any more players foul out. Only four people on the bench as of right now.
Just another area where, oh, nice play. Oh, nice block.
Gogolin shot blocked by Altabelli, and then a little scramble ensues.
Altabelli,
fighting for the ball.
She's quite a physical player, and she's doesn't back down under there. She's missed a few bunnies, but she's playing some tough D for sure.
Canestrari decides to drive. Nice effort, can't finish. Altabelli grabs the rebound. Now Powers has it for the Panthers. Throws it inside Altabelli. She turns, shot blocked by Gogolin. Off of Canestrari's hands, out of bounds. Still Holliston ball.
Well, I'm not sure if we're going to have a fantastic finish. It's not looking that
way. I'd bet against that at this point.
But we still have to play the string out, as they say. And Holliston, you know, this is a again, you mentioned it earlier. There's only four players on the bench for them that look to be available.
Right.
And one of them has four fouls.
Mm-hmm.
And you look at the Hiller bench, and there's about seven girls waiting
right
to get in. So
some who haven't played yet, so
exactly,
who have a lot to give. So it looked like a good opportunity there for Gabby Ramirez-Brodeur, but she is called for the charge.
Coach Keith not agreeing with that.
There's not much Coach Keefe has to be happy about tonight, but fouls certainly can't be one of them.
Exactly. We have a girl that we don't have her number, 45. I'm sorry, we'll have to look into that. Maybe somebody can help us out with that.
And it looks like Ramirez Broder took a spill on the floor, and Lakasha was called for a foul, and she looked up confused as if, what, who, me? And honestly, I have to say, I have to agree with her. Normally, she's got something to say after a foul, but this time, didn't look like much happened.
Exactly.
Kazuball is the ball picked by Callie Corby. Now Hawkinson on the break.
Marissa Prahl in the game, number 25.
Ball inside, shot up. Nope, never mind. Now it goes up, and I believe that's McDonald. Because we had this problem last time.
That's
she
right,
came
okay
up from.
Have to check our notes.
Yep.
Well, that was a heck of a shot.
Yep. Tough one to fall in there. Ramirez Broder steps on the end line, on the out-of-bounds line, trying to get away from the Hiller pressure. No luck there. And another Holliston turnover. And now
wholesale changes going on here.
A new platoon coming out for the Hillers.
31-point lead.
The all-senior lineup. I was wondering. I thought he was Coach Greco was going to start with it, but now.
Oh, there you go.
Looks like all seniors in the game except for one. And we are getting word that number 45 is Ashley McDermott, not McDonald. I was close, close but no cigar.
It's a good attempt. I mean, you're in the neighborhood, you right know what I mean? At this point, we can, Allie Mafiori taking a couple shots at the line, and she hits the first one. I'd like to thank our producers, John Ritz and Mike Tiger Tarosian. I invented that name. I might get fired because I keep on mentioning it. Director Tom Dings, graphics, Samantha Dings, cameras. Good job by Bob Hamilton, John Ritz, and Andy Ritz. Always doing a stellar job here. Appreciate everyone's time volunteering.
Especially here on senior night.
Exactly.
Big night. And it looks like it will be a big win here for the Hillers, who have four more games, not including this one, here in the regular season. Games coming up against Bellingham, who they've beaten in the first meeting this season, at Millis and at Medway, who they both have beaten already, and then home here on the 17th against Westwood, which they won at Westwood by 1 point, so I'm sure that's going to be, and that will probably decide something towards the top of the TVL because Westwood has been up there, so I'm sure that's going to be a great game too.
I think you're right about that. I'll have to check my schedule, make sure I check with my wife and manager Donna and make sure I can make it to that one on the 17th. That's in a couple weeks, so.
Not to look too far ahead, of course.
Yeah, well, it's best to plan ahead. Keeps you out of the doghouse, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Abby Ray Wells drives. Shot no good, but she does draw the foul. Fourth one there on LaKasha.
She's had a good game. Playing aggressively. Hit a couple three-pointers.
First free throw, no good for Wells. Second free throw just trickles out and grabbed by Pucci. Mafior down low. Not the biggest girl, but whenever I see her out there, she's always down low in the post.
Nice move.
Fakes a shot, takes it.
Oh, too bad.
Just too short. And Pucci looking to clean it up, gets the rebound and draws another foul.
I think Allie on that play kind of was anticipating a little more of a defensive effort on the Holliston Panthers, and she had kind of a clear path to the hoop, but tried to adjust her shot. Pucci cleaned it up and got fouled, and she's got to miss the first one, unfortunately. But, again, I don't think there's any risk tonight. But
definitely something to keep in mind because they have been struggling.
Yeah, at this point, you want to just try to work on some of the parts of your game that you need to, and makes it up for the second one, so that's good.
Right, not to diminish Holliston's status here and as an opponent, but they're not the best team that Hopkinton will face. And going into the playoffs, they're probably going to need to shoot, which I imagine they're shooting around 50% from the line. We don't have the numbers in front of us, but that's at least the general feel of it.
Yep.
And they're going to have to shoot a bit better than that when we get into the postseason here.
Definitely. Looks like a foul on Lauren Hamm, senior.
Pass inside, off the inbound, goes off of a foot. Looked like off of Canestrari's foot. And now a couple seniors, Canestrari, LaKasha, and Pucci taking a rest as Prawl, McDermott, and Corby come back into the game. I'm not sure how much more we'll see of Canestrari, Pucci, and LaKasha considering the score.
We haven't seen Elizabeth Liberti yet,
right,
junior.
She's the only one, I believe. Well,
my old neighbor, so I'm kind of rooting for her to get in the game. Oh, nice move.
I mean, we do have a little bit of pull up here.
We do. We influence the coaches. They get quick word of what we're saying, and then they make adjustments.
Right,
in the game.
Accordingly. Prawl there fouled, and she will be shooting now from the line. First one off the back of the rim, rolls out.
Got Ashley McDermott back in the game. We have her name now, so we want to make sure we get that right. Number 45 for the Hillers.
And Prawl knocks down the second. Now a 53-18 lead for Hopkinton. With a minute and a half left. in the third quarter. Shot fired from Abby Ray Wells. She knocks one down from deep.
No hesitation. Almost stepped out of bounds on the sideline and just launched it and rattled it in. That was good for her.
Mafior at the free throw line. Nice pass inside to McDermott. Her shot off the mark. Wells in trouble, gives it up. Three fired and good off the backboard from Ramirez Brodeur.
I don't know if she called glass, but good for her. Good to see a couple points go up for the Holliston girls. It doesn't look like it's going to matter in the end result, but nothing but building a little self-confidence for these girls.
Ball knocked away, but Ham recovers it for Hopkinton. 30 seconds left in the half, 10 seconds left, or 30 seconds left in the quarter. 10 on the shot clock. Shot fired from Ham. Baseline, two-point jumper is good. And she gets on the stat sheet, this time in the points category.
Is that a three-pointer or a two-pointer? But anyway, it was nice to see her launch one, hit nothing but net.
Seven seconds left now for Holliston. Shot fired from Elkinson, short, grabbed by Mafior, and that will do it here in the third quarter. The Hillers now with a 31-point lead, up 55-24.
Well, I don't know what else to say. I'm running out of – we can start talking about 1970s cartoon trivia if you want. That's a little before your time, but no, I'm just kidding. But it's certainly fun to have to have everybody heading into the game. Oh, we have a little announcement here. So let's see what this is about. It's like a 50-50 raffle situation going on.
Looks like.
Young man's got his.
The number is 7717199.
So he's got this Julian Edelman shirt on tonight, which is. See a couple of them walking by.
Thank you very much.
So where are you going to be watching the game, Tim, on Sunday? I'm assuming you're going to watch the game.
Yes, right? Yes. Okay, so one of my friends' houses.
Okay.
Yep.
You guys need to behave.
Got my spot all carved out.
Okay.
Of course. No, of course. Come on. Yeah. You tell me to behave. Come on.
Well, you're only a year out of college or something, right?
Right.
Yep. I'm a few more years than that out of college. But we.
You would never know.
Yeah. Well, thank you. We like to have a good time, too, even in our age bracket. So.
Quick turnover there for Holliston to start the fourth quarter. Again, the Hillers up 55-24. Shot fired from Ham. She knocks it down.
Boy, she's got 2 3-pointers in the last 30 seconds of the game. So,
and the bench went crazy there. Gogolin and Morningstar up on their feet.
That's
cheering
good.
On him.
Definitely. Senior night, she hits a couple three-pointers. That's the good time to do it. So, ooh, nice pass.
Shot fired a bit too strong from Gabby Cummins.
Ooh.
Looks like she got popped in the mouth there. Looks okay, though. Ham drives over to Mafior. Baseline shot, no good, but McDermott with the rebound. Now Hopkinton resets. Ham open for three.
Oh.
Knocks it down again. Lauren Ham.
They're getting the video going on the bench over there. Those girls are all fired up. That, you know, that's good for her. She's got 3 3-pointers in the last minute or minute and a half of the game, which is fantastic.
A temporary stop there to check on Holliston's Rachel Elkinson. She took a elbow to the face. Looks like she's okay. Loose ball around, grabbed by Brodeur. Her shot trickles in.
Nice
Gabby
roll.
Ramirez Brodeur.
Nice shot by Ramirez Brodeur. Got herself squared up. Hit a nice shot. Nice ball movement.
Yeah, great passing around. Prawl finds himself open for a three. No good there, but Hopkinton, with the offensive rebound.
I think Ham's looking to launch another one. She's on fire. Plenty of time in the shot clock.
They get it over to her. She fires. Just off the mark. Knocked out of bounds. Looks like off the hands of Gabby Cummins.
I think this place would have erupted if Ham hit that fourth right. one.
Timeout called here as Ham gets swarmed by teammates going over to the bench.
Well, this is getting a little bit of a stretching out the lead, as they say. It was sort of a foregone conclusion a while ago, but we're hanging in. It makes it harder for the, you know, it's a tough gig anyway, but when you have a 34-point lead, if my math is correct, and you're just sort of rooting for some good basketball the rest of the way, and then so far, you know, this both teams are playing out the string, and I think we're in good shape here for a win for the Hiller girls, and we'll see. You know, they were on a pace to score 80 points, so we'll see if they can get there.
Looks like, I imagine them to slow down a little bit here towards the end, but you never know. If Hannah keeps hitting those threes, we could see 80.
You never know.
Regardless of if we see 80 points or not, the Hillers will improve to 12-2 overall, 12-1 in the TVL with that one loss to Medfield. And again, looks like they should improve to make that 9 wins in a row now, with their last loss coming to Coyle Cassidy in a non-league game. So really, ever since then, the Hillers have just not looked back, and now we're at the top of the TVL.
Boy, I mean, they're going to be
a force to be reckoned with.
Definitely,
for sure.
And I think you can kind of see where this is going. I think they're Division 2 or 3, you know, in the playoffs.
Not off the top of my head. I think 2.
Yep. And they're certainly positioning themselves to get a high seed with some home games going on. Ashley McDermott with 2 foul shots. Missed the first one, and good to see her get some playing time. I'm assuming she's either a freshman or a sophomore. Nice shot. We'll have to do our more research on that, but we at least we got
we'll get
a
our
name.
Stats team on that.
Yep, exactly.
Now a 61-26 lead for Hopkinton.
Oh, unfortunately.
Bounce pass out of bounds there for Abby Ray Wells.
Yeah, right
a little
to
bit
the
miscommunication.
Right to the assistant coach. Which that wasn't really by design, I don't think.
Just under 5:50 left now here in this contest. Again, the Hillers host Bellingham here on the February 7th. Their second to last home game. They've beaten the Blackhawks already this year.
Oh,
Ham
boy.
Fires another three and knocks it down. Double-digit points now for Lauren Ham.
Heating up quick like a microwave. She's hit four three-pointers in the last couple minutes. Maybe 3 minutes.
Ball bounces off of Prawl's leg there, stays with the Panthers. And the Hiller bench is just loving this production here from Lauren Ham.
Yeah, that's a good story right there. And I hope she gets her name in the paper and all that kind of stuff because she deserves it.
Loose ball ends up in Coleman's hands.
Nice roll.
Her jump shot bounces in.
She's a scrappy player. Melanie Coleman.
She's had 4 fouls for a long time now. Hasn't picked up that 5th one. Although she has been on the bench for some of that time.
Yes. They're definitely feeding Lauren. You can kind of tell. Everybody's kind of rooting for her. If she keeps it up, she could be a leading scorer. I know Michaela Pucci's got quite a few. And
and Gogolin also.
Yep. It's good to spread it around a little bit.
Ham open again. Thought about it.
Oh, nice move.
McDermott shot. No good. Mafior with the offensive board.
Oh, too bad.
Looks like that's going to end up in Holliston's possession. It was going to roll out of bounds or be back court. Either way, Panthers take over. And Wells looks to get it in. Stolen away by McDermott, now corralled by Corby. Hopkinton looking to use as much clock as they can here at the end with this win all but official. 5 seconds left on the clock now. Prawl, baseline jumper. Just hits off the front of the rim. McDermott, offensive board, no. Mafior grabs it. Offensive rebound and bucket for Mafior, the senior.
Wow, there's just like, you write the script, all these seniors that don't necessarily get as much playing time as some of the others, and they're just really doing a great job. Everybody's pulling their weight tonight.
McDermott with a nice rebound there. Passed it over to an outlet, and Prawl, Mafior both thought the other was going to get it. Ball rolls out of bounds. Back to the Panthers. 3:37 left in this contest. Hiller's up by 38.
That's a big number.
Yes, it is. But almost exactly what we saw last time, a 70-36 win in Holliston for these Hillers. And now looks to be about the same margin, if not bigger this time. Ham fires the three. This one off the backboard. But Hopkinton gets another rebound. Not much is going Holliston's way today.
No, it's been a long night for them. But they're playing it out pretty good, and they're not giving up for sure.
McDermott inside. Nice. Mafior, she can't handle it. Ball taken away. Gabby Cummins with it for Holliston. Nice cut there from Kazuball. She needs help now.
Could be a 3 seconds in there. Been in there a long time. Good hustle.
Ball rolling on the ground as Elkinson gets her hands on it. Now a few subs for Holliston.
Well, if you look at the Holliston roster, they have one senior and a bunch of sophomores and juniors, mostly juniors. So I think next year would be a little bit more of a competitive situation for them.
Right. Mafior open under the hoop. Bit too strong in the reverse lane.
Good idea. Good feed by Ashley McDermott. She's got a nice game. Likes to play at the high post and dish the ball out.
Another big body for Hopkinton. Coleman knocked down there by McDermott. Her first foul. With 2:07 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Again, Hillers look to improve to 12-2 and maintain that hold on the top spot of the TVL, which has been tightly contested this year. Millis, of course, always good, and Westwood and Medfield have had very good seasons thus far. But Hopkinton has had wins against both of them, and now they sit in control of the TVL at number one. But it's not clinched yet. They can't take it easy. Westwood and Medfield are right behind them. And the Hillers have one more game against Westwood.
Nice shot.
Here in their final game on the 17th as Coleman knocks down a three. 35-point lead now for Hopkinton with a minute 40 left.
Boy, this so far is sort of a carbon copy score-wise from the last time they played, which was about a 70-35 score. Oh, nice move.
Allie Mafior, another offensive rebound. It says here on the chart that she is 5'4", and she's gotten at least three or four offensive rebounds.
Yep, she's scrappy too, a lot of depth. You know, a little NBA carry. See, again as an, that's the kind of they let you get away with that carry in the NBA and even in college. But
the ball kind of hung up there on Coleman.
A little bit. That's a tough call with a minute left in the game when you're down by 30 something points. But
it's not going to be the reason they lose.
No,
so.
Exactly. Oh, nice.
Mafior open again.
Ooh, yep. Too bad. I think she got a little travel there. Yep. Good idea, though. She had a nice ball.
Felt the defender coming. Tried to adjust her feet. Ended up traveling. Now just under a minute left now. Another turnover for Holliston here.
That's a tough pass that Coleman had. She couldn't do anything with. It was kind of pulled her out of bounds, and she had nowhere to go. About 45 seconds left, a 37-point lead. I'm not mistaken by saying that. It's one of the bigger leads we've seen.
While we have some time here, just want to give another shout-out to our crew here tonight, our producers John Ritz and Mike Terosian, director Tom Dings, on graphics Samantha Dings, and on cameras we have Bob Hamilton, John Ritz, and Andy Ritz. Thank you, guys. See some fans here taking an early exit. Trying to beat the traffic,
I
suppose.
The rush, yep. People have places to go. It's Friday night.
Yep.
8 o'clock. Night's just getting started for some of us. Some of us are going to be hitting, you know, going to cozy on up soon. No.
That free throw bounces around. Grabbed by Altabelli. Now just half a minute remaining here in this final quarter. Abby Ray Wells fouled on the drive, stopping the clock with 26.4 seconds.
Lauren Hamm, early on, got a couple fouls in. She launched about five for six three-pointers and hit four of them in about a four-minute span, and bringing a lot of energy to the Athletic Center here tonight, bringing all her teammates off the bench. That's a nice little side story tonight. Allie Maffiore, really scrappy senior, had a great game tonight.
Looks like the Hills will just dribble out this remaining time. 13 seconds and counting left. Holliston still playing tough defense, though. Haven't given up to their credit. But the Hillers will take this one 69-31 and improve to 12-2 on the season. 12-1 in the TVL, while Holliston drops to 6-10 overall and 6-8 in the TVL.
Boy, Tim, that's a heck of a team. And I'm sure the rest of the next three, four games with, you know, Bellingham on Tuesday night at home, and then Millis and Medway and Westwood coming up after, they're all going to have their hands full with this team.
Right.
They're deep, they're tall, athletic, well coached, and they're on a roll. So great way to kick off the weekend. Good time doing the game. I guess we'll see you on Tuesday night, right?
Right, absolutely. And here at the wire-to-wire victory again, Hopkinton takes it 69-31. 12-2 now on the season, sitting firmly top the TVL standings. We thank you all for listening to us here tonight and hope you join us again on Tuesday. Have a good night, everybody.